When it comes to recording voices, then it is nowadays common knowledge that all you need to do that is a microphone and a computer. The way this works is that the microphone creates an electrical voltage according to the sound waves that hit it, and the computer simply samples this analog voltage with a specific frequency, like 44,100 Hz, and saves those data points. When it comes to playback, the computer then reconstructs the analog signal from the data points and sends it to a speaker. Now, for a modern computer, this is certainly not a hard task. But what is in fact quite interesting is that the Atmega 328P microcontroller of the Arduino can handle such audio recordings as well. So in this small project, I will show you how to create an Arduino voice recorder, which might not offer the best audio quality possible, but can, due to its small size, easily be abused as a spy bug
to record all kinds of interesting conversations.
Let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB, where many engineers turn designs into real boards to make projects look more professional. Order high-quality PCBs for insanely low prices, currently even with free shipping. When it comes to the qualifications of the Atmega 328P for audio recording, we obviously must take a closer look at its datasheet. To be more specific though, its ADC, aka analog to digital converter, is most important, which, like the name implies, turns analog voltages into digital values. There are two decisive parameters: its resolution of 10 bits and its fastest conversion time of 13 microseconds, which would equal a sampling rate of around 76.923 kHz. Those values are quite low if we compare it to ADCs of modern sound cards, with sampling rates of 192 kHz and a 24-bit resolution. So while sound cards are recording tons of data points with small steps to one another, we will be recording a more bumpy ride, but it should still work. For the microphone, I went with an Electret 1, which, with just its integrated amplifier, creates peak-to-peak voltages of up to 100 mV, which is sadly too low for us. Now, of course, we could create an adequate microphone amplifier circuit, like I did in my DIY or by microphone episode. But to keep it a bit simpler this time, I went with a pre-made amp circuit based around the MAX9814IC. It offers a cascade amplification of 60 dB, which equals a gain of 1000. But best of all, it controls it dynamically, with its automatic gain control, which means it will amplify quiet noises and suppress loud noises, so perfect for our application. To connect it to the Arduino, I simply had to hook up its power pins to 5V and ground, and its output pin to the analog pin 0. And by the way, even though the microphone's recordings will consist a bit of white noise, it is pretty easy to fix with the noise reduction tool of the software Audacity. But anyway, in order to save the recorded data, I will be using a microSD card adapter, whose SPI pins along with its power pins need to get connected to the Arduino's SPI pins, 5V and ground. All that was left to add to the prototype was a tactile switch between pin 2 and ground to start/stop the recording, and a LED with a rather high value resistor of 2 kOhms between pin 6 and ground, to discreetly act as a recording notification light. And with the hardware being completed, it was time to create the code that should mainly sample the analog signal periodically and ultimately save the data on the microSD card. To do that, the required code would look something like this, which I obviously not wrote by myself. It is in fact the TMR PCM Arduino library. With its help, I created a simple Arduino sketch that starts a recording with a sample rate of 16,000 Hz when the tactile switch is pushed, and saves it as a WAV file on the SD card when the switch is pushed again. As already stated, the LED acts as a notification light, and the code can create up to 10 recording files. and after connecting the Arduino with the computer, uploading the codes, and inserting the microSD card, I tried out the setup and realized that there was no problem with it. As an endurance test though, I let the Arduino record for up to 2 hours, which was also no problem at all. Perfect. In order to turn this prototype into a proper spy bug though, I replaced the Arduino Nano with a smaller Arduino Pro Mini and added a small LiPo battery with TP4056 charger and protection circuits to the mix. According to my finalized schematic, I then connected all of the components to one another on a piece of perfboard. And of course, you can find the schematic and more information about this project as always in the video description. After I was done soldering all of the mandatory components to the front side of the perfboard, which also includes soldering 3 longer wires to the microphone and connecting them to the circuit as well, I then added the microSD card to the backside of the perfboard, in order to keep the spy bug as small as possible. And once I hooked up the battery and uploaded the codes, this time with an FTDI breakout, the system worked again without a problem. What was still optimizable though was the circuit's current draw with around 20 milliamps. By using a battery capacity of 160 milliamp hours, that would equal a runtime of around 8 hours. So to decrease the current demand slightly, I removed the voltage regulator and the two LEDs from the Arduino Pro Mini board, which resulted in a total current draw of 18 milliamps, and thus a recording time of around 9 hours. And with that being done, we got ourselves a small, long-lasting and easy-to-use spy bug, which I advise you to not use for something unethical. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed watching this small project, and maybe even got ideas for one of your own projects. If so, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!